Hey guys. Man, we need a Simone this morning. Let's get this shared out so we can get started. But we are going to be dealing with those shitty voices in your head. We're going to talk about what they're going to try to do today and how to mitigate them. It is March 24, 2022. If you are watching this on any other day than today, this information is definitely for you. Okay, just trying to get this stuff set. All right, Robin, turn off Nina. God, just love this song. Ready? 1, 2, 3, off. Okay, let's talk about the shitty voices in your head. Your head, my head, all of our heads, okay? They're going to be loud today. They're going to be trying to get, like, you are making progress, right? You are totally making progress on whatever it is that you're working on healing, the new habits you're working on creating, reaching your goals. You're making progress. And your subconscious is like, shit, wait a minute, things are changing. I don't like change. I don't know. Change is not safe. And the rest of your brain is like backing this up, man, because the thing is, your brain is designed to save energy. And one of the ways that it saves energy is by not changing. It takes a lot of energy to change belief systems. It takes a lot of like brain energy, like using up glucose and all of that good stuff, right? Your brain doesn't want to do that at all, because that's not what it feels is, that's not what it's designed to do. So what are we going to do today? What are we going to do about these shitty voices in the head? The stuff that's telling you, no, things are not going to be okay. No, it's not safe to make a mistake. You know, oh, do you remember what happened last time you did this? Oh, and let's bring up memories that are going to make you feel guilty. And memories that, even if you don't recognize it, are going to cause you to feel some level of shame. That's going to stop you in your tracks, right? And it does. It absolutely does. But you don't have to listen to this. Here's the deal. You have everything you need to override those negative voices in your head. No matter where you are in your healing journey, no matter where you are in your emotional journey, you have what you need to do it. I am not saying that it will be easy. Some things are harder than others, but you have it. And if you allow yourself to dig down below those voices, you will absolutely find examples that prove those voices wrong. And it's not like it's this one example of like, oh yeah, you know, that was just a fluke. You will find consistent examples. You will find consistent examples of the words that were spoken over you by authority figures in your life, that they were wrong, that those words were wrong. The problem is that you get so attached to who you think you are, that you get so attached to the identity that you have created, or that has been created for you. Forget about that you be created. You get so attached to the identity that's been created for you that it makes it difficult for you to accept the evidence That proves it all wrong. The evidence is all around you. If you need help finding the evidence, I want you to reach out to me. I want to have a conversation with you. I guarantee you, I will find the evidence that it's wrong. I guarantee you. Reach out to me. We'll have a conversation. I will find the evidence that those voices in your head are wrong. You get to ignore them. You get to ignore those voices. Now, look, I don't like to tell the voices to fuck off because a lot of times they are coming from a part of you that is very, very deeply wounded. And by telling them to fuck off, it hurts, it hurts them. Okay? And let's get real. Sometimes you're just not in a place where you can turn around and say, oh, part of me that's telling me I'm a piece of shit. Oh, part of me that's telling me if I make this mistake, my entire life is going to be ruined. Oh, part of me who's telling me, oh, you overdid your protein last night. That means your entire diet's going to fail, and everything you did was for naught, and you might as well just go eat the cheesecake. Right? You just may not be at the point where you can say to that part of me, you know what? I get it. I know that you're hurting. But we are not the same person anymore. And I love you. And just look at all these wonderful accomplishments we've made. Look at how we've proven this wrong. You might not be in that space where you can do that right now. Okay, so tell it to fuck off. Go put it in a timeout. Tell it to go in its room and suck its thumb for a little while. You'll get back to it later. Or say, I love you, but fuck off right now. I need to deal with this. Like, you get to choose how you respond to that voice. You do eventually want to get to the point where you can start speaking kindly to it. But if you are not there yet, that does not mean that your healing needs to wait. Your healing begins right now. Right now. So when those voices start happening, have the conversation. I don't give a fuck what the conversation is. Have the conversation where you take control and get them to shut down. It may take practice. You're not used to it. I get it. It's a new habit. No problem. Do not start beating yourself up because you haven't been able to do it yet, though. And even if you've been working on this for a while, I want you to recognize that even though the voices are still here, I know that they are quieter than they were before. They may be bothering you 25% less than they were before. You might be taking 10% more action in spite of them, than before. The progress is there. I know it is there. I know it is there. I know it is there for you. How do I know? Because I'm looking at the energy of it. Even if I don't know the individuals who are going to be sitting here, even if I don't know you as a single individual person, when you're going to watch this, if you are watching this and all that kind of stuff, but I know because I can see the energy of it, that when the person who was watching this is listening to this, they are one of these people for whom progress has been made. That's part of the gift of being able to see the energy. So even if you are not certain, you borrow my certainty. You just borrow my certainty that progress is being made, even if you don't recognize it. And then you come back and you listen to this again. As I remind you again, I know that you are making progress. I can see it. Even if I can't see you, even if I don't know you as an individual, I don't need to. I see the energy. I feel the energy. I feel the certainty. I feel the strength. I feel your success. I see your success. I see you quieting the shitty voices in your head. I see you taking the actions, the necessary actions, the healing actions, the forward, the life-giving actions, the forward-moving actions that are going to continue to move you in the direction of your success, move you in the direction of your dreams, move you in the directions of loving yourself more, at least liking yourself more. And beating yourself up less. I see all of this. Whoever you are, wherever you are, no matter what you believe, I see it. I know it. So take a second to allow yourself to receive that, to whatever degree you can receive it. I don't care if you're sitting there saying, Robin, this is a bunch of bullshit. There's still a piece of it coming through. So recognize that. Matter of fact, let's take a second. Put your hands over your heart and close your eyes. And I don't care if you believe it or not. What I want you to say is, it is safe for me to receive this. It is safe for me to receive this. It is safe for me to receive this. You say it out loud. You say it in your heart. I don't care how you say it. Put the passion into it. Even if you don't believe it, that's okay. Go ahead, lie to yourself. That's fine. Lie to yourself with the emotions, though. It's safe for me to receive this. It's safe. Even though I don't believe it's safe for me to receive this, I'm gonna let it be safe for me to receive this. Even though I can't fathom that any of this is possible. I get to receive this. I get for it to be safe to receive this. It gets to be safe for me to receive this because it does. It's safe for me to quiet down the voices in my head. It is safe for me to make choices that are opposite of what those shitty voices in my head are telling me. It is safe and okay for me to make the choices that propel me towards better quality of life. I get to make those choices because I do. I get to tell the voices in my head that I hear them and I recognize them and I'm doing what I want to anyway. I get to do that because I do. I get to be who I want to be. Instead of who the voices in my head tell me that I am, I get to be because I do. And it's safe and it's okay for me to do that. And I know how to live my life without those negative, shitty voices in my head telling me what to do. Of course I do. Of course I do. Of course it's safe. Of course it's this way. Of course it is. It is because it is. Take a deep breath in and exhale. Notice the change in your body. Notice the change in your mind. You get to live life from a space of kindness to yourself. You get to live life knowing when it's appropriate for you to reach out and help others, and when it's more important for for you to reach out to yourself and help yourself. You get to have the strength to go through whatever healing you need to deal with and have so that you can improve your quality of life. Somebody in the manifestation lab yesterday, we set intentions. We do our intention setting ceremony on Wednesdays, and their intention was world peace. Do you know how you get world peace? You find peace within yourself. People who have peace within themselves don't need to fight. They don't need to have a pissing contest. They don't need to be right, or they don't need to have somebody else tell them they're right. They don't need to base their self-worth on other people's judgments. They don't need to base their self-worth on having power over people. They don't need to base their self-worth on material items, on awards, on material successes. They already know they're worthy because they do. They already know that they are deserving because they do. They already know that they're loved because they are. And they don't need to argue with somebody whose opinion differs from theirs. So world peace begins within you. So you make peace with those voices in your head. That's the goal. Until you get there, you take the steps you have to take to mitigate the damage. Okay? Make sense? I hope it does. Questions? DM me. Post it in the comments. Share this out today, please. This is a super strong message coming through today. Share it out. The more people who are healed, the better life becomes. Because there's less friction. People who are healed have less friction. Now, there's always new layers to your healing. Absolutely. There's always new layers to your growth. And when I say less friction, there's always going to be friction because friction does help you to grow, right? And we're not here to stay stagnant. We are here to experience the wholeness of life. But we can do that without being abused. We can do that without being beat up. We can do that without somebody else making us feel small. We can do that without somebody else chipping away at our self-worth and our confidence. We get to. You get to. And again, if you need help with this, what did I say before? If you can't find in your life the parts, the experiences in your life that are proving those negative voices, those shitty voices in your head wrong, I want you to DM me. I will find it. I always do. It's up to you to accept it. But I always find it. Ask any one of my clients. Sometimes it pisses them off. Which is kind of fun. That's my humanness speaking. Oh, well. Anyway, I hope you have a phenomenal day. Remember, if you want to get on my calendar for a consultation, definitely reach out to me now. I don't have anything before April 5th. And I haven't looked at my email today, so I don't know if even that's accurate anymore. It might not be until after April 5th. Let's get you going. Let's get you on this path towards healing, towards wholeness, towards having the quality of life that you want, towards having the life that you want. Not only having the life that you want, but being able to feel it. Let it be fulfilling. So many people have the things that they want, and then they still don't feel fulfilling. Let's get you into that feeling of fulfillment, of joy, of happiness, of experiencing the wholeness of life, and knowing that you can handle it all. I'm going to stop now because I could go on for another hour. And I know it's just not appropriate at the moment. So reach out to me, DM me. All right. Have a phenomenal day, whatever day you are watching this. And also, if you're watching this after March 24th, that's still, go ahead, reach out to me, DM me. Facebook or Instagram, easy enough to find me. Robin Jana Rosenhaus, all over the place. Okay, guys, have a great day. Remember, when you align your energy, you accelerate your results. This is Robin Jana Rosenhaus, and I'm out of here.